Before I demonstrate how onGrasp actions work in the interaction grasp detector script, you'll need to understand how static callback and dynamic callbacks in Unity events work. I'll include a link in the description to a video that goes into some detail about these tools, but I'll also quickly summarize it in this video. Take a look at this screenshot. The Testing Unity event script has two functions. Print greet message takes in a game object and prints it to the console. Print greet message v2 takes in an iInteraction behavior object and prints it to the console. The interaction behavior class can be found in leap.unity.interaction. I added this script to the object watcher. As you can see in the onActivateUnity event, I call printGreetMessage and it requires that I specify the game object to pass to the function in the UI. This is because onActivate is a static callback. I know it is a static callback because there is nothing between the parentheses of onActivate. Static callbacks require us to specify the parameter in the Unity editor. Now let's take a look at onDeactivate and onGrasp. We call printGreetMessage v2 in both callbacks, but we have to specify the parameter in onDeactivate. This makes sense because onDeactivate is a static callback. However, we do not need to specify the parameter when we use the function in the onGrasp callback. This is because onGrasp is a dynamic callback, meaning that somewhere in the interaction grasp detector script, it is already passing the parameter for us. I know it is a dynamic callback because there is something in between the parentheses. This thing is the type that is passed to the function we specify under the callback. In our case, onGrasp is passing a iInteraction behavior, so we need a function that takes in an iInteraction behavior object. This is why I used iInteractionBehavior as a parameter in the printGreetMessage v2 function. In this screenshot, you can see that the UI drop-down menu is now divided into two sections, one for dynamic and one for static parameters. We can call the static version of printGreetMessage v2 in onGrasp, but that defeats the purpose of the dynamic callback. In short, dynamic callbacks are useful for when we don't want to statically set parameters. In other words, if we're unsure of the values to pass as parameters, we can use dynamic callbacks. You may find dynamic callbacks to be most useful when you want to pass parameters through code instead of through the Unity editor. For more information, you can check out the Unity documents on their site. Now we have a way to know which object we are grasping. We know that onGrasp can pass an object of type iInteractionBehavior via code. Thus, we created a function, printGreetMessage v2, that accepts an iInteractionBehavior object. Now, when we pick something up, you can see in the console window that the name of the object is printed.